महागणपतये नमः ओम नारायणाय नमः टुडे आल्सो आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग यू टू द कर न्यासम एंड अंग न्यासम एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द लॉर्ड इन अवर बॉडी एंड आल्सो सिंबॉलिकली शोइंग विथ साइंस थ्रू अवर बॉडी पार्ट्स सीकिंग गॉड इन अस हिज पावर्स इन अस हिज प्रेजेंस इन अस इज ए सिंबॉलिक जेस्चर एज अ मोड ऑफ वर्शिप. Now I will chant the mantras, and tomorrow we shall go to Chiro Darbanda, the further shlokas. Vishwam Vishnur Vashatkara Iti Angushtabhyam Namaha Amrutam Shudbhavo Banuriti Tarjani Bhyam Namaha Brahmanyo Brahmakrit Brahmeti मध्य माभ्याम नमः सुवर्ण बिंदु रक्षोभ्य इति अनामिकाभ्याम नमः निमिषो निमिषः स्रग्वी इति कनिष्ठिकाभ्याम नमः रदांगपाणि रक्षोभ्य इति करतल घर पृष्ठाभ्याम नमः सुबृद सुमुग सूक्ष्म इति ज्ञानाय हृदयाय नमः सहस्र मूर्ता विश्वात्मा इति ऐश्वर्याय शिरसे नमः सहस्रार्चि सप्तजिह्व इति शक्त्यै शिकायै वशत् त्रिसामा सामगः सामेति भलाय कवचाय हूं रदांगपाणि रक्षोभ्य इति तेजसे नेत्राभ्याम वौषट शार्ङ्ग दन्वा गदाधर इति वीर्याय अस्त्राय बट ऋतुः सुदर्शनः काल इति दिग्बन्धः इति ध्यानम् एतत् ध्यानम्. So let me explain as per Panini and everything I will combine here. So Vishwam Vishnur, Vishwasya Vishnur is a lord of the world. Is Vashatkaraha is a procedure for a Homa or a Yaga, like how to keep the bricks, how do you keep all the Darba, Kushagras and all the four sides, how do you say Borboswa, Om Borboswa, Devasabhya Prasuva, Satyendratain, all those things, all those mantras, how to keep the Umi, the chaff of the rice chaff, and then on top of it the cow dung's varati, and then on top of it the coal, the burning coal. It must be actually a coal from the, not the wood coal, it is a what they say liko, it is a earth coal, and the agnihotris have it for generations together. It should be burning in the house, that's what they say. See, all these are called the vashatkaraha required for a homa or a yajna. So vashatkaraha iti angushtabhyam namaha. So when you say namaha, you are praying to God, but you can also use your body parts, and then you can symbolize it and think of God, so that God, you are inviting him to be present in your body. Now angushtabhyam, now what is this tabhyam? In Sanskritam I told you, in the chaturthi vibhakti, which is two namaha means I am prostrating to you, or for you my prostrations is the meaning. That is the fourth conjugation, fourth vibhakti. Both in Pullingaha, Srilingaha and Napumsakalingaha, it will be always Tabhyam for duality, dual. Dvitiya, Dvivachanam. It's called Ekavachanam, Dvivachanam and Bahuvachanam. I have told you, singular, dual and plural. So that's why here we say Angushtabhyam. So two Angushtaha. Now what is Angushtaha? Angushtaha technically means the finger, the short thick finger at our palm, our hands. But it also means in Sanskrit, right toe and the left toe, the toe in our legs. So once you say namaha, you can symbolically, you can move your hand, that angustaha, that finger, short finger, and then you say, when you say namaha, you can think of God's Mahavishnu's padam, that is his foot toes, right and the left toes. Tabhya means two, to those two toes. Namaha, I am prostrating iti astaha. So you can just symbolically, you can just move your both your hand, finger and the toes in your leg. So symbolically, it is what in Samavedis, especially in Kerala and I think in north in western parts, they use lot of hand movements when they chant the Vedas. Just to symbolify God. In Kerala, it is very predominant because since I come from that place, we used to, all the pundits use shaigai, they will say, with the hand movements, more than mantras. But this is combination of both. The next one, Amrudam Shudbhavo Banuhu Iti Tarjani Bhyam Namaha. Tarjani means, it's a feminine gender, it is mean the four fingers, the pointing finger of both our hands. That's why Tabhyam. So I will, Tarjani Bhyam Namaha. So you can move your fingers and think of Bhagavan's fingers and then you can say this mantra. Brahmanyo Brahmakrit Brahmeti Madhya Ma Bhyam Namaha. All Brahma, you know, Madhya means the central of our body trunk, the central portion, the chest and also the backside. We have two parts, no? The left lung and the right lung and the left heart, left ventricle and the right ventricle, the spine, the Sushumna Nadi is dividing both. So both, that's why the Tabhyam comes. So Madhya, the central part of the body, when you chant, all Brahma only, you can tell like that, Brahmam Brahmeti only. Suvarna Bindu, the golden seed, Rakshobhya Iti Anamika Bhyam Namaha. What is Anamika? Anamika is a ring finger. The ring finger of the Lord, two ring fingers, and you can also symbolically slightly shake your two ring fingers and pray to God and he will come into your ring finger. These are all formality, these are all the methods, Vashatkara. So, Anamika Bhyam Namaha, Nimisho Nimisha Sragvi, Kanishtika Bhyam Namaha. Kanishtika Kanishta figure is your little finger. In the two hands we have the little fingers. So, Bhagavan's little fingers, Mahavishnu's little fingers, and you can shake your two little fingers of yours. And Suvarna Bindu means golden seed, no? Rakshaha, I explained to you yesterday, it is Anamika Abhyam Namaha. Now, Nimisho Nimisha Sragvi Kanishtika Abhyam Namaha. Sorry. So, Kanishtika Abhyam is a little finger. Sragvi, what is Sragvi? Sragvi is the garland, no? Which is stitched together, the flowers are together, stitched and placed together like a wreath or a garland. So likewise the time, what is the time? Nimishaha, all these minutes and nimishas, Vedic nimisha is different from English minutes, but they are all stitched together. So that, like a flower. So for that, the Kanishtika, the little finger, Kanishtika, Bhyam, Namaha, you pray to the God. They are using these words. Sragvi means a garland of flowers stitched together tightly, a wreath. So even the time, Nimishaha, is stitched together. Something like that. And Kanishtika Abhyam. So two fingers you have. Kanishtika Abhyam Namaha. Little fingers. Kanishtika means little fingers. Anamika means your ring fingers where you place your ring. It's called ring fingers. Radangabani Rakshobhya Iti Karatala Gara Prishtabhyam Namaha. Now what is Karatala? Kara means hand. Karatala means the, Karatalam, Devi, we will say in Sanskritam. So Karatala is the palm, the two palms. Karatala palm and Gara means sprinkling. See, we sprinkle ourselves, no? Atma Prokshanam. So we take the water from one hand to the other and just circle it, circumambulate it around your head. Om Bhor Bhuvat Suvaha, like that. We do that in our Sandhyavandanam, like that. So, and Prishtha means backside generally, but Puraha means front. But here Prishtha means all sides. You can take it as all sides. Prishtavaha means front and back. You can take it here. And technically Prishtavaha means backside and Purataha means front side, from the front side. So here you can take it both. So Karatala, palms, with the palms you can pour water if you want. Gara, sprinkle. Prishtha, all the sides, front and back sides of Swami and you also. Whatever it is, if you have a vigraha in your front, and you can do that. Suvrata sumaga sutshmam iti jnanaya hridayaya namaha. Jnanaya, atma jnanam. Jnana means knowledge. Atmajnanam. See where it is. It is in the chest. No, so Hridayaya, to the Hridaya. You pray to the seeing the God's Hridaya. Ask Him to come to your Hridaya. He is already there. He will reveal Himself. That's all. But as for our satisfaction, we are once again inviting Him. That is all. Jnana, Sukshma means very minute. Minute details like that. So, next one. Sahasra Murta Vishwatma iti Aishwaryaya Hirase Namaha. So, for all Aishwaryas, you chant this. Sahasra Murti, no, he is a thousand murtis, no, he is figures. And he is a Vishwatma. Sahasra Murta Vishwat, from the Vishwa he has come. Vishwat means Vishwaha Vishwat, Ramat, like that. So, iti Aishwaryaya, to Aishwarya, is Hirase, you touch your Siras, Swami Siras, you see. Swami Siras is always Aishwaryam, where the knowledge exists, you know. So, Aishwaryaya, your Siras also, and you say, Namaha. And next one, Sahasrarchi Sapta Jihva. So, Sapta Jihva, all of you know, seven tongues, they say, that I will come to you later on, it will come. Iti Shaktiyai Shikhayai Vashat. So, Shikha is the, Brahmins have the tuft, you know, backside. The vashat is, I told you, is a procedure for the yaga. So shikha is a must for a yaga. Generally, if you want to do a yaga, you should have shikha and tuft of the hair. So that has got the shakti, because shikha has got the shakti. That's what it means. And to that, shikha ye vashat. That is a procedure. The procedure of shikha is a vashat. To that you can touch your back if you have a shikha and say shikha ye vashat. Trisama, Samaga, Sameti. I told you yesterday, it's all the three Sama, recensions of Sama and Vida, and varieties of Sama. I have told you like Vrata and all those things I have told you yesterday, Proktam and everything. So, Trisama, Samaga, Sameti, Bhalaya, for the strength. Kavachaya whom? Kavacha means it's armor. So, in your hand, in your chest or in your area, that area, chest, stomach area, this Trisama Vedaha is the real protector. That's what Swami says. Bhagavan says, Bhagavan through Bhishma and through practice and mantras, it is the kavacham. It is which we can't afford to miss it. Radangapani rakshyobhya idi tejase netra bhyam vaushat. Again you have to touch your 2 ears, because for the tejas, the netra, radangapani rakshyobhya, the netra means eyes. Netrabhyam, 2 eyes for the tejas. So you have to touch that, you have with your fingers. It's a vaushat, vaushat, pallava, pratipataka, nama. Everywhere it is a vaushat, vashat, vashatkaraha, is the one which is having those complete procedures of yaga, vashat, vaushat, sraushat, all is there. All procedures required for homa, yaga, etc. Sharanga, Dhanva, Gadha, Dara, Iti, Viryaya, Astraya, but. So you can take your hands and swing. Yesterday we were telling, you know, all the four big Astra flies. So for all the Viryam, for the all the courage, the bravery. So Astraya, but. So you can swing your hands, circumambulate your hands along backside of your head and then bring it to the forward of your head like that. Ruduh Sudarshana Kala Iti Digbandaha. So this is the entire Digbandaha is surrounded by Sudarshana, the Pavitram, the richness, the prosperity, the wealth of all the citizens, all he is covering by Sudarshana. Nothing evil can approach you. All the directions, Digbandaha, he has tied up, he has locked with his Sudarshana. Everywhere only Sudarshana of the Lord will be there. So this is the meditation, Iti Dhyanam. After saying this, you can meditate on the cosmic form, the Vishwarupam of the Lord. Om Dirghaishman Bhava, Dirghasumangali Bhava, Sarva Vyadi Nivarana Praptirasto, Sarva Aishwaryam Abhivrdhir Bhavato, Sarva Mangalani Bhavanto, Tadhastu, Tadhastu, Tadhastu.